I'm a Dave and Buster's guy in a filibuster world. Can't believe they let me say that one. Count Dick Durbin among the growing chorus of voices on the liberal left who believe the time has come, and has long passed, to jettison the Senate's legislative filibuster. The Illinois Democrat, who also serves as the Senate Majority Whip, the number two leadership position in the party, went very public with his issues with the way the filibuster is being used in the modern Senate during a fiery floor speech in mid-March. Here's the key bit.
Today, nearly 65 years after Strom Thurmond's marathon defense of Jim Crow, the filibuster is still making a mockery of American democracy. The filibuster is still being misused by some senators to block legislation urgently needed and supported by a strong majority of the American people. This is what hitting legislative rock bottom looks like. Today's filibuster has turned the world's most deliberative body into one of the world's most ineffectual bodies.
This is what hitting legislative rock bottom looks like. You tell him, Dick. Speak your truth. Durbin made clear that he's open to reforming the filibuster rather than getting rid of it entirely. He proposed that if a senator wants to block a vote on a piece of legislation, he or she should be required to hold the Senate floor in person for as long as they possibly can, which is how most average Americans believe the filibuster works right now. Sidebar, the average American's perception of the filibuster comes from the movie Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, if I'm being honest. But that's not actually how the filibuster works in the modern version of the Senate. These days, a single senator can keep the Senate from trying to invoke cloture, a fancy word that simply means ending the Senate's unlimited debate and proceeding to a final vote with simply the threat of a filibuster. As in, a senator can simply indicate that he or she would filibuster a certain piece of legislation in order for it to gum up the works. As the Washington Post's Philip Bump wrote in January, quoting here, "In practical terms, filibusters these days are only rarely hours-long riffs driven by passion for a cause. They're much more frequently hand-wavy threats to offer such a speech with the end game of forcing legislation to meet a supermajority standard before passage," end quote. The filibuster has been badly eroded in the past decade or so. First by Democrats under Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid of Nevada, who opened Pandora's box in 2013 when he invoked what was then known as the nuclear option, eliminating the need for 60 votes to end debate on all presidential nominations other than Supreme Court justices. On those nominations, a simple majority was all that was needed to proceed to a final confirmation vote, transforming the Senate, at least in some parts, into a majority rules body similar to the U.S. House. So after Republicans retook the Senate majority in the 2014 midterms, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell was now steering the ship, and in 2017 showed that what's good for the goose is good for the gander, further undermining the filibuster by including Supreme Court nominees in Reid's previous filibuster changes. And that move, which meant that a simple majority of senators could end a judicial filibuster, allowed McConnell to confirm three Supreme Court justices in Donald Trump's four-year term: Neil Gorsuch, Brett Kavanaugh, and Amy Coney Barrett. Which brings us to this moment, with Democrats again in the majority and with a Democrat in the White House in the form of, yes, Joe Biden. So liberals, having watched Trump and McConnell fundamentally alter the ideological makeup of the most powerful court in the country for a generation, now want Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer to move to get rid of the filibuster entirely, including on all legislative matters. Quote, "Preserving the filibuster is not worth letting millions of people in this country go hungry, sleep in their cars, or struggle to afford baby formula," tweeted New York Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez in February. Now, the problem here is that Democrats don't have the votes to change the rules, at least not yet. So in order to change the Senate rules, Democrats need all 50 of their members to back such a move. And at least two Democrats, that's Joe Manchin of West Virginia and Kyrsten Sinema of Arizona, have said they don't support the elimination of the legislative filibuster. Manchin said back in July 2020 that eliminating the filibuster was, and I quote, "bullshit," and he continues to insist that he opposes such a move. However, in an appearance on Fox News Sunday in early March, Manchin seemed open to what Durbin backed in his speech, forcing a senator to hold the Senate floor for as long as he or she possibly can, which is also known as a talking filibuster. Here's Manchin.
"If you want to make it a little bit more painful, make him stand there and talk, I'm willing to look at any way we can, but I'm not willing to take away the involvement of the minority."
President Joe Biden, himself a long-serving member of the Senate, opened the door to the talking filibuster in an ABC interview in mid-March.
You have to do it what it used to be when I first got to the Senate and back in the old days. You had to stand up and command the floor.
Biden, however, has made it very clear he is against the wholesale elimination of the legislative filibuster. Now, despite that opposition, there's no question that pressure is now building on the likes of Manchin and Sinema and even Biden to reconsider their views on the filibuster. Why, you ask? Good question. Because with a Democratic-controlled House, a Democratic president, and a Democrats in control of the Senate, admittedly solely because Vice President Kamala Harris breaks 50-50 ties, but that's not that important, many liberals view these next 2 years as a unique moment to push long-hoped-for legislation. That includes gun control legislation, which has already passed the House, aggressive efforts to slow climate change, and policy proposals designed to counter Republican efforts at the state level to limit voting rights. The House has already passed H.R. 1, which would usher in a series of election and voting reforms, but the Senate hasn't acted. Quote, there's no way under the sun that in 2021 that we are going to allow the filibuster to be used to deny voting rights, said South Carolina Congressman Jim Clyburn, the number three ranking Democrat in the House and its most powerful African-American member. Clyburn added this, that just ain't gonna happen. That would be catastrophic. End quote. Durbin's vociferous argument in favor of changing or ending the filibuster will further amp up attention on the issue. Will it change the minds it needs to? That's honestly the big question. And for his part, Mitch McConnell strongly warned Democrats that Republicans will grind the Senate to a halt if the filibuster rule is altered. McConnell laid out a conservative agenda that Republicans would push the next time they take control of Congress and the White House, and assuming the filibuster was gone, most of which Democrats would vehemently oppose, like defunding Planned Parenthood and adding sweeping restrictions against abortion. So the pendulum would swing both ways in McConnell's argument, and in his words, it would swing hard toward Republicans, he warned. And he's right about that. That's the danger. It's also the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.